Happy Monday, everybody! You're listening to the Personal Playlist Podcast, fondly referred to as the P3. I'm Noah Daniel. I am so excited to have Dr. Monica Burns here on the Personal Playlist Podcast. Monica is a curriculum and EdTech consultant and founder of ClassTechTips.com. As a classroom teacher, she was part of her school's leadership team and used digital tools to create an engaging, differentiated learning experience to meet the unique needs of her students. Then, Monica started ClassTechTips.com in 2012 to help make EdTech easier for fellow educators. And now, she visits schools across the country to work with teachers to make technology integration exciting and accessible. In addition to being named an Apple Distinguished Educator in 2013, Monica completed a doctorate in global educational leadership at Lamar University in 2016. She has presented to teachers, administrators, and tech enthusiasts at numerous national and international conferences, including South by Southwest EDU, ISTE, FETC, and EduTech. She's the author of Tasks Before Apps, Designing Rigorous Learning in a Tech-Rich Classroom for ASCD, Formative Tech, Meaningful, Sustainable, and Scalable Formative Assessment with Technology for Corwin, and is the co-author of 40 Ways to Inject Creativity into Your Classroom with Adobe Spark, including several other publications. Monica is also the host of the Easy EdTech podcast. Welcome to the show, Monica.
Thank you so much for having me today.
I'm so happy to have you here today. So after doing all of this and becoming that person that people go to, why did you start the podcast?
Well, it's something that I love as a consumer. I listen to lots and lots of podcasts and really appreciate the medium. And I had a few people start to ask me, you know, are you going to do a podcast? That's, you know, another way to connect with people. And I was really hesitant to take on another project, right? With a lot of things going on. And I don't like doing things if I'm not going to really put a lot of effort behind it. And so I finally felt like I had the space to bring that into my work. And I started first by taking some older blog content that I loved, but I knew needed a little bit new energy or new updates, and started doing that and sharing that on the podcast. I've had some more educator interviews this past spring, especially trying to be more responsive to the current climate and thinking about remote learning challenges and wanting to make sure that what I was providing was really valuable and actionable is always important to me. So that was part of that little bit of a pivot. And I've got some more author interviews coming up this spring. But I love the medium. And I think it's been great to have people hear from me just when I get really excited about different things, because, you know, a blog post is lovely and I consume a lot of content that way too. But I think it's a different level of connection and just remembering when someone else shares how much they, you know, are excited or how they feel about something. You just have a different type of connection. And I know that is true for myself as a consumer. And I thought it would be interesting to explore that. And it's been over a year already. And it's been a really fun place to share, and always excited to hear feedback and have people tell me that they listen to the podcast, because I know there's so many people's podcasts I listen to. So it's an interesting way to just foster some new connections.
It is. And it's funny, like I started following you, I guess, a long time ago. But when the podcast came out, it was interesting to be able to hear. I like to listen first and then I go do the reading. So it was great to hear from you some things that you love, always like the tidbits that you offer. And I think it's really helpful. So I listen to podcasts for different reasons. Sometimes I listen to them as like an observer or a listener. But for your stuff, it's really like, what can I take away from this conversation that I'm going to go and do, and that's going to make my life easier and really make it better for my students, because that's what it's all about.
I appreciate you sharing that, because it's definitely, you know, part of my mission is to kind of have things that are ready to use, right? I love big ideas, but if we want to take those big ideas and put them into action, you know, we need to be strategic about it. So thank you for sharing that.
But I think the other part about what you do just in terms of strategy is really keeping the students in mind and not just getting dazzled by the ed tech, which is a differentiator for you in your work for sure. In my work, oh, sorry, you were going to say something.
No, I was just, as you said that, I was just thinking about how, you know, we all have those moments where we walk around an expo floor and get really excited, you know, and we see something fun and flashy, and it's easy to get into that mindset. But you're right. I think, you know, even though now I've been out of the classroom for several years, and of course, working remotely to support educators right now, you know, over the past few years, just up until February, you know, I spend time in classrooms with students, and I think it really helps as a reminder of what's possible, what's, you know, what's really something we want to focus on, especially if we only have a little bit of time together with a group of students, we want to make sure it counts.
Yeah, it's so true. You really want to have a full experience and pack as much as you can into those moments. And it's good to have those experiences with students because it grounds you in the why of your work. The why of my work is really about personalization and creating opportunities for people to tell their stories. And this project that is a podcast came from my classroom, and it's something that grounds me all the time in terms of what can be possible for creating opportunities for learners. So in terms of this as an opportunity for you, how did you feel about finding three songs for your playlist?
It was interesting to think about the categories that you shared because, you know, music is definitely a big part of my life as a consumer, which I'm sure most, you know, many people feel the same way. But it's interesting when you get more personal and think a little bit more reflectively. And we all know we hear a song and we get transported back to a moment or to a feeling or to a connection with another person. And so it's always interesting to narrow down and reflect in those moments.
It's hard to narrow it down, especially if you're a music lover, but you brought me three songs, one that's nostalgic, one that reflects your identity, and one that picks you up, lifts you up, inspires, or motivates. So let's go to that throwback song. What do you think about when you think about this song that you chose, and why is it that you chose it to tell this part of your story?
So I chose a Jolene by Dolly Parton because it's a song that just is all the feelings, I think, for me, and makes me think of kind of singing along with other people or having a shared moment, because I think it's a song that just resonates for so many people. And recently for me, and I think one of the reasons it's been front of mind as a throwback song, is that I was listening to the Dolly Parton's America podcast, and it talked so much about her and her place in American history and how she just represents all different parts of the United States was kind of their big thesis going through the whole piece and the storytelling that went alongside with it. So I found myself listening to a lot of Dolly Parton recently, which I hadn't done in a long time. Thank you. I can't say her name, but A-L-E-X-A, otherwise she'll hear me in the office, right? But asking the robot to play all the songs. And so, you know, it had that kind of throwback piece, but part of the nostalgia for me was the fact that I kept telling people about this podcast that I was listening to. And my mom has been listening to more podcasts recently, and she was listening to it, and we would talk about the episodes, and it, you know, other people would message me and we'd talk about it. And it just became this thing where, you know, it was rebuilding some connections, I guess, is what I'm getting at, with people who I might not have those kind of deep, what do you think conversations with all the time. And it's one that just resonated for me in that kind of throwback mindset, even though it's something that I've been spending a little bit more time in recently.
It's funny when you're talking, I don't know the podcast that you're referring to, but, you know, she's an incredible woman. And this song is a song she wrote because she was jealous about this woman, but not really so jealous that she told her husband not to talk to him anymore, that he worked at the bank with at one point. And she has, by Hollywood and rock and roll's standards, a very long-standing, healthy, wonderful marriage. And her husband's a farmer. And so it's so grassroots America in so many ways. And it's interesting that she's been a topic of that podcast because I can see why she's so important. Never mind all the things that she continues to contribute every day with her read alouds and all the philanthropic work that she does.
Absolutely. And I'm a big reader. You know, I like to read lots of things, but I tend to be more in the memoir or biography space. It's always an area that I just kind of lean to, even with audiobooks. And so the idea of her as a role model, as someone whose life is fascinating or that I think I can learn from, or all of those things too, just makes her such a compelling subject. And her storytelling through song is so powerful. And even if you haven't had experiences that exactly mirror it, right, when it comes to the exact story she's sharing, the feelings alongside those stories, I think everyone has had in some way. And so it's so relatable in that aspect. And that's one thing that I think of with that song too.
No, I agree. It's funny. It came to my house, even though it was on my playlist, my daughters heard Miley Cyrus doing a version of it with Dolly Parton. And it's now part of like our kitchen cleanup playlist because they love it and they can find connections to it. So songs that have that kind of longevity, that have, you know, that both time, place, and space, that can come from anywhere and connect to anywhere, really just reflects how essential her work is and how a song like this can be so nostalgic while also being so modern. And let's play it, Jolene by Dolly Parton.
Of auburn hair with ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring. Your voice is soft like summer rain, and I cannot compete with you, Jolene. He talks about you in his sleep, and there's nothing I can do to keep from crying when he calls your name, Jolene. Understand how you could easily take my man, but you don't know what he means to me, Jolene.
Powerful to talk a little bit about feelings about something and then kind of hearing it together like that. It's just, it's a favorite song.
It's so good that a song from your past can be a favorite in your present. But the next song is a song about you. How did you feel choosing it? And what does it say about you, Monica?
So the next song that I chose was Holes to Heaven, which is a Jack Johnson song that I love. He's probably the person that I've seen perform live. I'm not a huge live music person. I have a lot of friends and family members who make a much better effort at going out and seeing a live music and favorites. But he's someone that I've seen multiple times live, and this is probably one of my favorite songs by him, but with this idea of choosing something around identity or something that reflects an aspect of who I am, this just made me really think about, you know, picking a song by an artist that I love that has an emotional connection to it, because it's a song that I listened to the album, gosh, over and over and over again during a period of my life when I was in the car a lot, you know, or going to the beach a lot, or those kind of memories. And so the idea of being outside and looking up to the stars, which is really what this song is about, is something that, you know, just makes me feel of all those kind of free moments. I grew up not too far from the beach in New York. And so spending a lot of time kind of all seasons, you know, not just summertime at the beach, but wintertime at going down to the beach or you know, just driving down for sunset or any of those kind of things that I feel very lucky to have had that experience. This song is one that just reminds me of being outside and near the beach, even on cold days.
It's so nice that, you know, Jack Johnson can speak to you in that way and remind you of the places that you are, but also a piece of yourself that you don't always get to tap into. And I guess during quarantine, being outside has been the saving grace for so many of us and the sanity that we need. Have you gotten a chance to be outside a lot during this time?
So I live in the city. So I live right outside of New York City in Jersey City, New Jersey. And folks who follow along on Instagram have seen me post plenty of pictures from around here. But the month of May, I was able to spend some time out on Long Island, not exactly where I grew up, but not terribly far, and spend some time outside with more of the wind and the walks and the May weather. And even though, you know, I live here in the city, I spend a lot of time outside just kind of on activities or from one place to another. And even though we've been more inside, of course, you know, during this time, I've tried to make sure to still carve out that, you know, go on that long walk, even if you don't have a destination in mind the way that I might in the past, because I think that's so important.
Well, let's play your identity song, Holes to Heaven by Jack Johnson. About the Patricia Polacco book, Thank You, Mr. Falker, because when she talks about her grandparents, she talks about the stars being that light to heaven and that they went to the other side. But I think that it's one of the things that really makes me feel better in this time of being inside is that we can all look at the stars. And even though they look a little bit different in a different hemisphere, it's something that we can all look forward to connecting through. It must say so much about what you love.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of my favorite songs for sure. And he's someone, like I mentioned, that I've followed along pretty closely. So even choosing, you know, a song, right, from an artist that you're so familiar with is sometimes hard to pinpoint. But, you know, I think for this song too, you know, and just like you said, I mean, absolutely with that connection piece, I think is very much a part of it. But, you know, I always think of this as a sunset song almost, right? Like a end of the day kind of song, of just that, you know, transition from day to night. And I think I associate it with, you know, that sort of being by the beach or the sun setting or something. And, you know, I feel very lucky that the past, gosh, 5 or 6 years or so, I've been on the road a lot, which can be exhausting, but it also has lots of wonderful pieces to it as well, of just being able to see different parts of the country, especially. And I will joke a lot about chasing sunsets in different places, because those tend to be the pictures that I snap when I go someplace, you know, or I'll try and find a rooftop, or I'll ask the person at the hotel, where's the best place to go to see the sunset here, you know? And so it's funny when I think, you know, about a lot of the travels that I'm not doing now, but that I've done so much of in the past. It's one of the things I'm very, you know, I think back to all those spaces and all those places, and that kind of sunset piece, I think, is a nice common thread that goes between all of them.
I love that idea that you're chasing sunsets. It's so perfect. And it's a perfect way to segue to your last song because it's the end of that. So your last song, which the category is Pick Me Up, Inspirational, Motivational, and Pump Up, because really you can take whatever that song is that shifts your zone, whether you need it to feel better or you need it to feel more connected or to get going or to feel revved up. You chose this last song in a really timely way. So why don't you tell us a little bit about the song and why you chose it?
So I love the song Lovely Day by Bill Withers. It's just one of my favorites. And for this category, I think it's, I love this category and it's such a perfect fit for that. This is one of those songs when I kind of don't know what I want to listen to, or I don't know what mood I'm in, or I'm getting ready to leave or to go somewhere and kind of need to shift on right to that, you know, that positive mindset. This is one that is a go-to song on that list of kind of fun and lighthearted and all the, you know, gratitude type of feels to it as well. This is one that only recently I started playing when I present, or, you know, especially if at like a conference or an event where I might have like a 15 minute or so couple songs to play to just kind of get myself excited and get other people in the room, you know, just settled in. This has become one that's been on rotation for that the past year or so, because I think it is just one of those songs that makes people happy, even if they don't know why. And this is right, just all the pieces of it. And so this is definitely a favorite.
It's so sad that he passed away, but his legacy and being inducted into Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, but his legacy as a songwriter and singer is something that will certainly stand the test of time. And since we've been in quarantine, I've seen Lean On Me come out, but it's nice to bring Lovely Day into the picture and to bring about the whole idea that here's a person who found sunshine wherever he could. So it's an amazing example, even though many people came to the song because of that Gap commercial years ago promoting khakis. It's really nice to honor him. He, you know, it was only 2 months ago that he passed away. So let's play Lovely Day by Bill Withers.
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind, then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Instead of me, always seems to know the way. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
That he set the record for the longest sustained note on a chart hit on American charts, holding that high E for 18 seconds in the chorus.
No, I didn't know that. Although that makes me feel, that's funny because I think, of all the times I'm singing along with a song, and you're like, oh, I
You
can't
just
hit the notes
can't.
with her, or I can't do that, right? So it's a little validating, right? From a personal space to say, I never can get that whole note or, whatever in between. But no, what a great fun fact. I love it.
It's not an attainable exemplar in any way.
Right.
No. How do you feel about sharing your three songs with me today?
I loved it. I love this format. Definitely getting more personal than I sometimes do, right, with sharing, because I think that's one of the wonderful things about music is that, right, it's one of those sneaky things, right? It sneaks up on you and makes you really think about different pieces and different parts of your life and how different pieces of music, fit into all of those times and how when you hear something, it brings you back to all of those pieces. Hopefully more often for better, right? When we listen to a favorite song. So I really appreciate going through this exercise with you and just love the format. So thank you so much. It's such a gift to take some time to really think about those pieces.
I love that you said sneaks up on you. I will always say that music is a way in and a way out, but you're right. It's more than a laundry list of tell me about yourself. It's kind of a sneaky way of getting into those pieces of you that you don't always get to share, which makes me so happy. Let's tell people where they can find you.
Yeah, so I share in lots of places all of my blog posts and my podcast episodes. You can find on my blog, classtechtips.com, and my podcast is called the Easy EdTech Podcast, which is in all the podcast places, wherever your favorite place might be. And then I'm on social media at classtechtips, and Instagram is probably the place I'm the most active. I'm trying to give updates and sharing things there too. So if you have any questions or want to connect with me, you can always send me a message at Class Tech Tips on Instagram.
Well, thank you so much. And I'm so happy that I got to know you in this way. I've been listening to you and learning from you for a while. So it's always special when I get to get into these conversations, just like you were saying about your show. Like it is, it's an intimate space to take a deep dive. So thank you for letting it be about you and through music. Is there anything you want to add before I play you out?
No, this was lovely. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much. I hope you have a wonderful day.
You too.
Thank you for joining us on the P3, the Personal Playlist Podcast. I'm Noah Daniel. This is Voice Ed Radio, and I hope you have a fantastic day.